We get asked constantly about ways to improve aim, and understandably so. Having good and consistent aim is just so important if you want to see successful results in this game. With some weapons, even a single shot can be what determines the outcome of a fight. And of course, nobody wants to be that guy that chokes by missing a vital shot. What's going on, everybody? I'm your host, Dan, back with another video. This time, all about the fundamentals of aiming that you need to land more shots in Fortnite. I'll be explaining a lot of the theories behind aiming in Fortnite and how using that information can lead to more effective shots. Keep in mind that along with every other mechanic, just knowing the theory isn't enough. You need to be able to apply that information so that you can learn through practice. Yes, even if you know every aiming technique and how to properly use every weapon, you'd still need to regularly train your mechanics in order to see results. So just try to keep that in mind as we start the video. If you're looking to take your gameplay to the next level, I recommend that you guys check out InstaPro, where we have live 24/7 coaching from some of the best players in the game. Head over to ProGuides.com right now. Trust me, guys, you won't regret it. With that said, let's get into the good stuff. Okay, so the first thing we need to talk about is how to use weapons in effective ways. Each weapon in Fortnite has its own use, and depending on the situation, what weapon you use can make a huge difference in the outcome. When first deciding on which weapon to use, you need to keep in mind its effective range. This is especially true after the combat shotgun got vaulted. Players were used to that weapon being so useful at longer ranges that they're still treating the pump almost like it, but the pump shotgun has a much shorter effective range in the combat. You need to be really close to your opponent, like within 3 tiles distance, if you want to land a solid hit. If you're farther away than that, the damage really starts to fall off. It's usually better to start firing with a rifle or SMG instead of swapping to them after a pump shot. The damage you do with the shotgun at those greater distances just isn't worth it when you factor in the time it takes to swap weapons. You can even use the pump's effective range to your advantage when in sticky situations. Let's say you take a chunk of damage in a build fight and now you're on low health. By boxing up, any opposing players on the offensive will be forced into a very close range if they want to finish the kill. Then, all it can take is a quick edit or two and some nice pump shots to quickly turn the fight in your favor. This is why so many players nowadays default to boxing up when things go wrong instead of trying to build their way out of it. The pump is just so good at equalizing situations where one player has less health than the other. Next, let's talk about when to utilize first shot accuracy and when to just spray instead. First, you normally only use first shot accuracy engaging players at long distances. On some of the more bloom-heavy weapons like the heavy or suppressed assault rifles, you want to try tapping to maintain first shot accuracy at these distances. Both of their blooms become pretty bad once you fire around 4 or 5 shots, at which point you'll just start missing everything. At closer ranges, just like with several tiles, it's not as necessary to rely on, and you can still be pretty accurate shooting without it. Compared to those weapons, the regular assault rifle is much more accurate while being sprayed, even at longer distances. If you had nearly perfect aim, using first shot accuracy would, of course, be better, but for most of us, spraying outputs more bullets and can potentially lead to more hits landed. So for most situations, spraying with a regular AR is just fine. We would say that you should only try using first shot accuracy at extremely long distances, like at 100 meters plus. What about headshots versus body shots? Well, headshots are always better. If you can land them. Big if there. At medium to long distances, it's often better to just go for body shots. The target is much bigger and you're so much more likely to land some hits. If the target is standing still or is really close to you, then by all means, go for the headshot. It won't be too hard to hit in those situations. But when they're 75 meters away, running around or gliding in the air, the body ends up being a much easier target to go for. One thing you need to always make sure you're doing in gunfights is to constantly try peeking on the right-hand side. Right side peeks are beyond instrumental when it comes to winning close range encounters. Because of the way our characters hold their weapons to the right, peeking on that side allows you to shoot sooner and without revealing as much of your body. There even exists a sweet spot angle where you can see and shoot your opponent, but they can't see you at all. You don't have to worry about finding the sweet spot. What you need to make sure you're doing is strafing right for a quick shot, then strafe left to duck behind cover. You can repeat this with a shotgun really well to land shots and minimize risk. When done correctly, it gives your opponent very little time to land their own shot. The best way to utilize right-hand peeks is in conjunction with edits. Like anytime you go for a window edit, you want to confirm the edit while you're to the left of the window. That way, you can strafe right and get that peeking advantage. You generally want to avoid edits that force you to peek to the left-hand side, like any wall or floor edit on the left side of the piece. That is, unless you're not right in front of the piece and are instead strafing right towards it. We're not saying these edits have no use, but they're generally riskier to make as your opponents will have a larger opportunity to retaliate. Next, crosshair placement is one of the most fundamental aspects of aiming in nearly every shooter game out there. The idea is that you always want to keep your crosshair at a position where you're making as little of an adjustment as possible when you go to shoot your target. Basically, it's making sure your crosshair is pointed at where you think the enemy will appear. When done right, good crosshair placement can help you land shots sooner and with higher accuracy. Newer players at first need to always be conscious of their crosshair's position, but with enough practice, you'll start placing your crosshair at the right spots instinctively. So, for instance, let's say you're about to turn a corner in a house and you're expecting an enemy to be around it. You'd want to have your crosshair placed ideally at head level as you're turning the corner. You also need to make sure you're not aiming at an area there's no chance your opponent is at. Aiming at the ground, at the wall you're turning, or just straight up not paying attention to your crosshair placement means it'll take more time to adjust and land the shot. And quick timing is essential when it comes to winning these sorts of engagements. By the time you do go to aim on your opponent, you would have already gotten hit by them, losing the trade and potentially the encounter. The same thing applies to when you're editing. Players often make the mistake of confirming edits while their crosshair is placed in a spot far away from the target enemy. Whether it's editing a wall or a ramp, you need to be getting into the habit of placing your crosshair near or on your opponent before you confirm the edit. If you don't, you'll have to rely on landing fast flicks to win the trade. When you're in a build fight playing the low ground, crosshair placement normally ends up determining who gets the first shot off. The player on the low ground needs to track their opponent's position by following them through their build. If you can do that, you can set your crosshair at the spot you think they'll peek. And with the way peeking works, you'll actually have a solid chance to land your shot first. They first have to reveal some of their head and body before firing, at which time you can get a shot off. Good crosshair placement and player tracking are skills that low ground warriors must possess if they want to win encounters. Okay, so let's just have a quick discussion on when to aim down sights and when to just hip fire. With this topic, it's not about having higher accuracy, it's more about keeping yourself alive in fights so that you can output more damage. You always want to be careful with how long you hold down your sights while shooting. It turns you into a very easy target when you're standing there firing your weapon. At extremely close distances, aiming down sights doesn't provide enough benefit to normally make it worth doing. Rifles and SMGs are still pretty accurate being hip-fired within a couple tiles distance, so it's often more effective to maintain good movement and forego the slightly better bloom at those ranges. If you strafe left and right and even throw in a few crouches, you'll become harder to hit while at the same time maintaining similar damage output. For controller players, the situation's a bit different, since aim assist is tied to when you aim down sights. Controller players understandably can rely on aim assist, so throwing in a quick left trigger every now and then isn't necessarily bad, even at the closest of ranges. Again, you just need to make sure you're not staying aimed down for too long, or else you might just get easily killed. Making sure to take your time while aiming is a simple way to greatly increase the impact your shots have. There are two weapons in the game where taking your time is most beneficial: shotguns and snipers. With shotguns, especially the pump, missing a shot leaves big room for punishment. Usually, players try to go for flick shots with the pump, but instead end up just whiffing. Crosshair placement can help reduce the number of times you'll need to flick, but hey, let's face it, we're not all pro aimers, and flicking is one of the toughest techniques to pull off consistently. So unless your flicks are on point, it's often better to take your time and make sure your crosshair is on your target before pulling the trigger. We're not saying that flicks are bad or anything, but some angles are just so extreme that flicks end up being too risky. Like, landing your shot first doesn't matter if you only do 30 damage versus your opponent doing 100. Taking your time can help a ton with shotguns. Whenever you're trying to snipe an unsuspecting player, missing the shot punishes you hard. It alerts enemies and gives away your position in a trade for nothing. With the heavy and bolt action snipers, you normally only get one shot that counts. And so, waiting patiently for the right moment to fire can be super useful in helping you land that opening hit. For instance, if you see players fighting in the distance, it's often better to wait for one of them to start shooting or go for a heal. They'll stand still or tighten up their movement enough to make landing a shot a much easier task. If you see a player not fighting and just running around, it's usually better to wait for a predictable pattern before firing a shot. A skilled player is going to run unpredictably and change up their movement, making snipes very difficult to land. But your average player usually leaves two vulnerabilities in their movement that you need to look for. First is when players just run in a straight line, which anyone with enough sniping experience should be able to consistently lead a shot for. The second is when players jump. Once the jump starts, they're on a predictable path down to their landing. Taking advantage of this and aiming for where they're going to land can make hitting snipes a breeze. It can be a bit risky having to wait for these openings, so you shouldn't take too long waiting for their movement to slip up. Just try to make sure that you have good cover and positioning to help you keep safe while sniping. Learning the specifics of aiming and how weapons work in Fortnite definitely helps you land more shots. But remember, despite all the tips and tricks, practice is still a very necessary part of acquiring good aim. If you need more info on how to get that raw practice, you can always check out our last aim training video here, where we discuss how to work on and improve your aiming mechanics. If the video helped you guys, be sure to drop a like and let us know what you think. Thanks for watching, everyone.